Hey there, it's me, Grace, and today, in honor of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ's birthday, whose day we celebrate on Christmas, I wanted to make this baby Jesus cloth, and I really think that you're going to enjoy it. I enjoyed coming up with this pattern and design, and just really hope that you enjoy it too. It's a whole lot of fun. There are several steps to it, so just kind of hang in there with me, but we'll get through it, and it'll be good in the end. So let's get started. The first thing I'm going to do is apologize for the lighting. Let's begin with a slip knot, and this is how I make mine. I'm going to start with my eye hook and I'm going to chain 20. Loosely, but not sloppily. Now that I have my 20, I'm going to work one single crochet into each stitch across. Of course, I can't go right back into this one because it would pull out. So I have to go back into this one. So this will be my first stitch. Okay, so a single crochet. If you're new to crochet, let me zoom in and show you. When you insert the hook into the foundation chain that we just made, you're going to insert right under that top strand. And if you flip this over, you'll see there are two strands underneath. And that's where they should be. And you'll find in the end that it'll make the cloth look more uniform because this will match the top. Because this will look like a stitched row, and of course the top will look like a stitched row. And when we put the border on, you'll see that this helps a lot to have those two right there as a stitch that you can work into. So insert the hook into the foundation chain, only pick up that top strand, go ahead and yarn over, which means that you just kind of grab the yarn with your hook, yarn over again, and pull through both loops on the hook. So again, insert your hook into the foundation chain, picking up the top strand of yarn, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two. That's a single crochet, and that's the stitch we're going to use for the entire foundation chain. So 20 stitches. This is the last one part of the foundation chain. Now that we've come to the end of the foundation chain, we're going to turn the work and chain one, or you can chain one and then turn. That works the same. I prefer to turn and then chain one. And we're going to work one single crochet into each stitch across. And we're going to keep doing this for three rows. So we have the first row here. We need a total of four rows of single crochet. I've come to the end of row four, and you should have as well. I'm going to go ahead and finish off these last two stitches. The next row is going to be somewhat different, so let's go ahead and turn our work and chain up one. Okay, We're going to work 5 single crochets. Okay, instead of completing the stitch on this 5th stitch, I'm just going to pull up a loop and we're going to go ahead and attach the brown. So just leave a generous tail that you can weave in later. Just grab hold of that yarn and pull it through and through. So you're completing the stitch, but only you're using the brown. So drop the blue for just a minute, and of course the tail of the brown. To keep us from weaving in so many ends later on, I want to go ahead and work across the blue and the tail of the brown. So we're going to carry the blue across because we're going to need it again. Okay, so in order to carry the blue and work across the tail, we're going to insert the hook just like we would make a normal single crochet, but instead we need to stop a minute and before we complete the stitch, make sure that those two tails are above the stitch that we're going into and below, of course, the thread that we're taking up, or the yarn that we're taking up, excuse me. So we're working across. We're going to take another stitch. Okay, let's go ahead and instead of legs on this manger, I'm going to make this a box manger. There are many styles of mangers. Some are just boxes and some are kind of like more like a cradle. But we're going to go ahead and go across. We're going to actually take 10 stitches. We've done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 7, 8, 9. And on the 10th one, we're only going to pull up a loop, drop the brown, pick up the blue, and complete that stitch. Alright, so I'll do that again because I think I went off the camera. Okay, so we're gonna just pick up a loop. Now drop the brown and pick up the blue that you've been carrying all this time and pick that up and complete the stitch. Now carry on just like you did before with only the blue. We're not carrying the brown, and there should be 5 stitches here. 2, 3, 4, and 5, and this last one might be a little bit difficult to get into. There we go. Okay. All right, so that's the end. All right, let's turn that. And this can get a little bit difficult the more yarn colors that you have attached. When you get done with the two rows, just like this one, I'll show you the next step. This is the end of the row, so now let's turn the work. This row is going to be exactly the same, except we're going to change from brown to yellow. Okay, so get your yellow ready, or whatever color you're using for the hay. Going to chain one and go ahead and single crochet into the next four. Okay, remember in the fifth one we're only going to pull up a loop. I'm sure you remember that by now. But let's go ahead and drop the brown. No, let's not. Let's work across the brown. We're going to carry the brown just like the blue. Okay? But instead of completing the stitch with brown, we're going to complete it with yellow. So let's add on the yellow now. Okay, and we can also work across the yellow tails. There's going to be a lot sandwiched in here, but that's okay. We can make it work. Okay, so let's go ahead and work the 9 single crochets of yellow, working across all those tails. I know that's a lot to squeeze in there, but I think in the end it'll be okay. It'll keep us from weaving in too many ends anyways, because the yellow tail will be caught in there. Okay, one more full single crochet, and then in the next one, of course, you're just going to pull up the loop. Alright, now drop your yellow, but don't cut it, because we're going to need it still. Drop the brown, pick up the blue, complete that stitch, and go ahead and finish out this row to the end just with the blue. Okay, the next row is going to be exactly like this one, so I'm not going to work it with you. I'll just, when you're finished and I'm finished, I'll show you the next step. I've come to the end of my row. The next thing I'm going to do is turn, chain one, and work back, of course, with my blue. I've got a pretty good tangle going on because I have so many different colors I'm working with right now. That's okay. Look at it all worked out in the end. Four. And then the fifth one, of course, we're only going to pull up a loop. This time, instead of yellow, we're going to drop the yellow. And this time we're going to drop it completely. So leave a pretty good tail. I would say leave a good couple of feet. And clip that tail, put your yellow to the side, pick up the brown, complete that stitch with the brown. Let's leave this yellow out of the way for just a minute. Okay. And of course, we're going to go ahead and carry that blue. We're going to work the 9 single crochet stitches. Alright, at this point we're finished with the brown. So let's clip a tail with plenty to weave in and put the brown to the side. At this point we've finished with the yellow, we finished with the brown. Now we're going to work 9 rows just with the blue. So when you're finished with the 9 rows of blue and I'm finished with mine, I'll show you the next step. I've completed my 9th row, and I'm sure you have too. And so the next thing that we need to do is add a border to the cloth. Now, if this is something that you're going to keep for yourself, you may choose not to, as I normally do. I don't usually border the cloths that I keep. But if I'm giving one away as a gift, I usually do put a border on the cloth just to make it look a little more complete. And so What I want to do now is go ahead and show you how to add that border. If you've been crocheting a while, you probably already know how, but if you're a beginner, I want to go ahead and help you learn how to put on a border. And this is a simple single crochet border, so this is not hard at all. Same stitch we've been doing, chain up one, and you're going to do another row back this way. So just like you did before, work into every stitch across just with a single crochet. And when you get to the end, I'll show you what to do next. I'm to the last stitch, so go ahead and take a single crochet, chain one, and single crochet into the same stitch, so the same stitch you just worked into. So we single crocheted, chained one, and then single crocheted into the same stitch. Now we're going to turn the cloth a quarter turn and work down the side. We're going to do the same thing, only this time we're going to work one single crochet into each row. So this will be the first row, this is the second row, third row, and so forth. This is the last one. So we're going to do just like we did in the first corner. Single crochet one, chain one, and single crochet back into that same place that you just did. Another quarter turn. This time we're going to work across the bottom. And remember in the beginning I told you that it was good that we were only picking up the top loop to leave the stitches on the bottom. And so that's going to make it easier for us to attach our border across the bottom. So work it just like you did across the top. Alright, this is, let's see, oh, I think I have one more. No, this is the last one. Alright, so single crochet, chain one, single crochet into the same stitch. Quarter turn, and we're going to work down the last side, and then I'll show you how to join it. I've made it to the end, and you should have two. This is the last stitch I need to make, so I'm going to single crochet here. Chain one, and I need to single crochet here again, and then I'm going to join right here just with a slip stitch. So just pull it through and through. Okay. So there are two ways to end off right here. You could just clip a tail and pull it through, or you can chain one first and then clip the tail and pull it through. It really is up to you. If you chain one first, it secures it pretty well because it makes a little knot there. If you don't chain one first, just make sure that you even the ends really well, but I prefer this method because when you chain one first, it leaves a little knot right there and you never can quite get that not to be hidden. It's always there and it just kind of makes a little funny lump right there. So let's go ahead and thread up the yarn needle and weave in the end. Now you certainly could do a second row around your cloth if you want to. Sometimes a wider border looks really nice. I'm going to stick with one for this project, but you can do as many rounds as you want to make the cloth as big as you like. I have just thread this up, I'm going to insert the needle through this next stitch and then back through the stitch I just came out of, and that will make it look like a stitch right there. Now, on the back of the cloth is where I want to weave in the ends. So I'm just going to kind of go back towards the back. I consider this the back. It's a little bumpier, maybe. It doesn't really matter on a dishcloth as long as they're woven in. I like to go down the side anyway. Just kind of go between the stitches there. And a good rule of thumb is to go 1 or 2 inches in one direction and then turn around and go back the opposite direction 1 or 2 inches. And generally speaking, that's good enough. So now I'm going to clip the tail. And you can just kind of work it out like that. The next thing we're going to do is, remember that long tail of yellow I told you to leave? We're going to thread that up into the yarn needle now. And what we're going to do is make some strands of hay, because hay doesn't sit still. It's not well behaved. It is just kind of all over the place. And so we're going to make it look like that. So I'm going to go back up through this stitch real quick. Okay. Bring this out to the front, or what I'm considering the front of the cloth. Okay. Now you have this strand of hay. And it's up to you to decide where to put it. It doesn't really matter. I'm just going to go through right up here. Well, I might not go that far up. Right here. Okay, turn over to the back. And what you might choose to do is kind of hide that in these stitches. Like this. Oops, that didn't work out. Let me undo that loop. Sorry about that. So that it's not so obvious on the back. And then just kind of hide the extra on the back. And then come back out to the front. And you can make another little stitch. Turn it over to the back, and then you can kind of hide that behind the stitches. Go back out to the front. Okay. Come out someplace else, and you know hay sticks off in all directions, so it doesn't really matter where you decide to put the hay. So just kind of work it behind the stitches, and that way when you turn the cloth over, or if somebody happens to be turning the cloth over, they won't see a bunch of threads all over the back. It'll be fairly neat. I think this is one of the most fun parts, is embellishing the cloth and making it look really neat. And this way, if it's not for you, if it's a gift, it's a little more polished looking on the back. If it were just for me, I probably wouldn't go to all this trouble to hide the threads, honestly. I would just let them hang out however they want to. But, you know, when it's for someone else, you want it to be as nice as possible. And so hiding the threads is kind of a good idea. It's a little extra work, but you get the idea. And so I'm going to finish up my hay and leave you to finish up yours, and then I'll show you the next step. I've completed the hay in the manger. Now I'm going to set the cloth to the side and take out the white yarn, my G hook, and start with a slip knot. I'm going to start working on the swaddling clothes. I'm going to begin by chaining 5. Again, I'm chaining loosely, but not sloppily. And that's 5. I'm going to work a single crochet into each stitch. Chain 1, and we're going to continue to work around this. So we're going to work a single crochet into the same stitch. You can go ahead and work across that tail that you have dangling there. That's fine. Okay. Chain 1 and join that to the beginning stitch that you made. These are the swaddling clothes. So we're going to clip the tail, pull that through, go ahead and weave in the ends, and then we'll make baby Jesus' head. I've completed the swaddling clothes and I've woven in the ends, so I'm going to put this to the side with the cloth. I'm going to take the skin color, which in my case is chamomile, and I am going to, instead of a slip knot, I'm going to make a magic loop, or what some people call a magic ring. I think I've even heard it called a magic circle, but whatever you call it, it's the same thing. It's a very, very loose slip knot. You don't tighten it until a little bit later. So go ahead just like you're going to make a slip knot. Just don't tighten it onto the hook. Chain 1 to secure it. And we're going to work 5 single crochets into the ring. Four, five. All right, take that tail, go ahead and pull it. We need to join with a slip stitch, so we're going to insert the hook into that first single crochet that we made, yarn over, and pull through, and through the loop on your hook as well. I'm going to weave in the ends, and I'll leave you to do the same. And the next thing we'll do is attach baby Jesus to the dishcloth. The next step is to attach baby Jesus to the manger on the cloth. So we need to clip off a little bit of chamomile, or whatever skin color you're using, and a little bit of the white. Okay. Let's do the swaddling clothes first. So we kind of want to position baby Jesus how we want him in the manger. He could be like this, or however you want him. Go ahead and kind of decide the placement. And the next thing you're going to do is thread up your yarn needle. ahead and come in from the back. And basically what we're going to do, of course, leaving a tail to weave in, we're going to just stitch around the outside. So just kind of in and out of the stitches here. Until we get all the way around, and then of course weave in the ends on the back. Of course now we need to attach his head. So we're going to do the same thing, only with the skin color, whatever skin color you chose. So go ahead and start tacking it on. And sometimes you have to give it a little wiggle like that, because if you don't, it's very stubborn, doesn't want to come through there. So this is going to work exactly like the swaddling clothes. We're just going to stitch around the outside and tack it down to the cloth and weave in the ends. And I will show you what to do next. Of course, at this point, your cloth can be done. That's completely up to you. But I feel like baby Jesus needs a halo because obviously he's holy. So let's go ahead and do just like we did for the head. We're going to start with a magic ring, or a loop, or circle, whatever you call it. Remember to chain one, secure that. Work 5 single crochets into the loop. Take that tail and pull it up. Okay, you're going to join with a slip stitch to the first single crochet you made. I might have pulled it too tight again. Work that into there. Pull it through and through. Okay. Instead of weaving in the ends right now, I'm going to use the ends to help me. So I'm only going to weave in this one that I just finished off. I'm going to leave this one and use it to tack the halo on to the cloth. Okay, I'm going to put the halo on. Like I said, you can be done at this point if you would like. I just felt like baby Jesus needed a halo, so I don't want him to just be just any baby in the manger. He's the King of Kings and he deserves a crown, so. Let's go ahead and put that on his head. It's just kind of hovering over him, as any halo might. All that's left to do is weave in the ends, and then we're done. Thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. And don't forget to tune in for the next Dishcloth of Christmas. Bye!